The gospel text of today is taken from the gospel of Mark chapter 3 verses 13 to 19 and speaks about the choice of the 12 disciples. Mark makes 3 points when he speaks in these verses, and the first is this, that Jesus went up to the hills. Going up to the hills or the mountain is a symbol of going toward God, because God was available in the heavens and the mountain was closer to heaven. And that is why when we are told that Jesus goes up to the hills, he is in a way asking God what exactly God's will is. The second point which Mark makes is that Jesus called those not whom he needed, because Jesus needed no one, but those whom he wanted. It was his choice. It was his wanting them, not needing them. So a deliberate choice that Jesus made. And then Mark goes on to tell us the reason why he wanted them. And that is the second point. Namely, he wanted them primarily, first, to be with him. What is the meaning of being with him? In Matthew chapter 11, verses 28 to 30, we are given an insight into what it means to be with him when Jesus tells his disciples, "Come to me, all you who labor and are overburdened, and I will give you rest. Take my yoke and learn from me, for I am gentle and humble in heart." So being with him means learning from the Lord, assimilating the Lord's way of life, interiorizing what the Lord will command me to do. Before I go out, before I get engaged in mission, I need to sit at the Lord's feet and learn from him. So when Mark tells us in the second point that Jesus called to him after going up close to God, those whom he wanted to be with him, Mark is giving us the primary purpose of the disciple. If the disciple is not with the Lord, it is very likely that the disciple might engage in his or her own agenda. However, if the disciple assimilates the Lord's agenda first, if the disciple interiorizes the Lord's way first, then it is very likely that that agenda would be the Lord's agenda. And that's why it is necessary for the disciples to sit at the feet of the Master and learn from him. Then Mark gives us the third point, and to be sent out. In other words, the "and to be sent out" is almost afterthought, is almost after sitting down at the feet and learning from him, though it is not a linear process. It is not as if one will sit at the feet of the Lord, learn, and then be sent out, because one can never stop learning from the Lord. And therefore, it's a cyclic process. One sits at the feet of the Lord, learns from him, and communicates that learning to others. And after communicating it to others, once again we sit at the feet of the Lord and learn from him and keep communicating it to others. In other words, it is a circle that has no end. It is a constantly assimilating and communicating, a learning and a giving. This is what the Lord invites his disciples to do. Will you, as a disciple of Jesus, assimilate the Lord's ways and communicate that way to everyone you meet?